Okay, so welcome back. In this class, we're going to cover how to write equations in WPS Office Suite. We're going to start with how to write basic equations, okay, to complex equations. So we're going to write these equations directly that we have. This is equation 1, equation 2, and equation 3. These are just images that I copied and pasted just for illustration purposes, okay? So we're going to write them in detail, okay? How to write them complete using WPS. So the first thing is we can come anywhere below here. We can just click to just give us ourselves a space. We're going to write this 11 plus x over x cubed plus 2x plus into 5 minus 3. So all you need is to come to insert. If you want to start writing any equation, you can see insert and you can come over here. These are the two things you need. Either a symbol, these are list of symbols that you can bring in at any given point, or you can come to equations directly. If you click on this small drop down or this drop arrow, you can see built-in equations that you can use. If you have used the equation editor in Microsoft Word, it's something very, very similar. You can see the very basic equations that you can have access to. You can see them, the Taylor expansions, the trigonometry functions, and the Fourier series. You can see all of them over here, the binomial theorems, you can see all of them. But then in this case, we want to write this very basic equation, okay? So you can come to equation, click over here, and you can see the equation editor. This is where you're going to do all of your typing. And by selecting equation, you can see it enables the equation toolbar. Over here, you have the list of different kind of objects that you can bring in. If you want to have access to the previous equations, like we've explained, you can see them from here. These are different kind of features or objects that you can bring into, or operations you can bring into your equations. And then over here you have the different functions, different functions like fractions. You can see the arrangement for fractions, different kind of fractions. You can see scripts, you can see superscripts, subscripts, and all that. Different kind of exponential functions, you can write them from here. And you can have radicals with brackets of different types, cube roots, square roots, you can see them over here. You can write different kind of brackets over here. And then we have the integrals. These are different kind of integrals with different limits, okay, as extends to from zero to something. You can define the limit, and any kind of integral, you can see them over here and you can define directly. And we have the large operators, okay? If you have large operators, you can see the features. All you need is just to select and bring it in, and then you can define the rest of the feature. And then you have different types of brackets, okay? Different kind of brackets are over here if you want to add any brackets. You have sine functions, the trigonometric functions, the sine, cosine, and the tan functions, and accents. You have different kind of accents over here, as well as limits. You can see limits as x turns to the log functions, operator functions, you can find them over here, and the matrix functions also, you can see them. Different kind of matrix in cases when you are designing a matrix. But for this one, we are just going to write this simple equation, 11x, 11 plus x. So at the moment, we can see that this is a fraction, the first function, the first feature over here. This is a fraction. So you can come to fraction over here and just click, and we have this little fraction. So you can see at the numerator level, you have 11 plus x, 11 plus x. So you can have plus x. Okay, come down to the denominator and you have x cubed. So this is subscript. So you can come to subscript over here and you click on this one because this is subscript. So you can put x, and then you can go to the subscript function and put the cube, and then you can come all the way here to the end, okay? And this is when you insert the plus sign, and you can come and put 2x plus 2x, 2x into, now you have a bracket, you can insert bracket, you can manually or from your keyboard, or you can come here, this is a normal bracket, so into, then you can come back here and say 5 minus x. Okay, and you can see now we've just written this equation perfectly, 11 plus x over x cubed plus 2x into 5 minus x. You can see this is very perfectly written in WPS. Now let's go into this a bit more complex equation to write with it. So let's click on enter to create the space that we're going to write. So you can see, as usual, you can come to insert, go to equation, and then you can start writing. So this one also on its entirety, it's a function, it's a fraction. You can come over here and come to fraction. So the numerator, this is when you have the negative b, and then you have plus or minus. So you can come to this. Okay, you should be able to have plus or minus here. You can see it over here, plus or minus. Then you have square root of, so you can come to square root over here, square root of what? So you can come down inside the square root of, you have now this superscript b squared. Okay, so you can come over here and say b squared, and then you can come down, okay, with the arrow, and then put minus 4ac, and then you can come everything inside the bracket and all over 2a. As you can see, this is perfectly written, and this is the equation rewritten in this format. Okay, so let's go to the more complex one, which is this one with the limit function. So you can just click. It's very easy to write. So you can still come down to insert, go to equations, and then you can come to this function. The first one, the left hand side is a fraction. So you can come to the fraction part and just write df. Df, you can come to the numerator, denominator, and dt. Okay, so you can now see the fdt, and then you can use the arrow sign and put the equal sign. This is equal to, now this is a limit function, so you can come over here. Where is the limit function? This one. You come to limit. So this is limits, but then you have to define it. So limit as h turns to zero of something. So this is the function we're after. You can come to limit as h turns to zero, so h with an arrow, so you can come and select this arrow that says turns to zero, and then we can have the next function over here written in this. So this is the next function, and you can see the entirety of the function is a fraction. So you can come over here and select this fraction, and at the top here you can put the fraction. This is f into t plus h, so you can see f, you can come to brackets over here into t plus h, so you can see t plus h, and then outside you have minus f of t, and then you can do the same brackets, okay, and then put your t inside f of t, and then you can come down to denominator, you can come down to denominator, and then put in this h. This is all over h. So now this function is now rewritten in this. So the whole idea is for you to know how and which of the equations you are going to write, how is it going to be written. You can just write it directly, okay? So in cases if you have to include any kind of character, you can symbol, you can also bring them different kind of symbols from here. In cases if you can't find them in the equation symbols, you can always bring them in from here. You can click to see more symbols if you're interested in seeing more symbols, and you can see them. You can check the different fonts, and you can check the different character. If you are interested in special characters, you can see them. Custom symbols, you can see them as well from here, okay? The symbols, you can come also subset, you can see Latin supplement, Latin hyperextension. You can check all the different kind of number forms, you can see different kind of symbols from here, okay? So basically this is how to write an equation and insert symbols and objects. I hope you enjoyed this video. In our next class, we're going to look at how to insert tables in WPS Office Suite. How to insert and format tables in WPS Office Suite. So, until next time, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye.